Hey everyone, welcome back. As promised, today we will be taking a look at Tree Zone. What can we expect in Tree Zone? Well, from the looks of it, bees, ants, and bird. I don't know what we'll find in Tree Zone, but whatever it is, I'm sure it'll be pretty crazy. I'm just really loving how different this game is from any other Mario game. This and Super Mario Land. I mean, it still feels like Mario. It kind of has the same feel as like Super Mario 2 in the US, which wasn't a Mario game at all. It was, as most people know, a game called Doki Doki Panic that they Nintendo retooled for the US Super Mario Bros. 2. Which is a much better Super Mario Bros. 2 than the game the Japanese got. I mean, nothing against the Lost Levels, but it's pretty much just more Super Mario Bros. 1 with a few little tweaks. I wonder how they have Super Mario 2. They call it Super Mario 2 USA, I think, in Japan. I wonder how that was received, or how Doki Doki Panic was received. I mean, a lot of things from Mario 2 / Doki Doki Panic made their way into Mario canon later on, like the Shy Guy, for example. So I wonder what they think of that game in Japan, if it's even on their radar. I was reading a website called Legends of Localization, which I highly recommend to everyone who's interested in video games. It's run by this guy named Mado, who was probably the most famous among gaming nerds as being, I don't know if he's solely responsible for or if he just spearheaded the fan translation of Mother 3. I know he had a huge presence in that project, but he has this website called Legends of Localization, and it's really fascinating. He talks about, I mean, he goes really in-depth about a few games. I don't know how often the site's updated, because I just discovered it. But he talks about Zelda. Zelda's probably the most fascinating one. But he also has these articles where he looks at games from, oh, this is a different minigame. Weird. Okay. Which one do I want? Well, I guess the 1-Up, although the carrot would be cool too. I don't know if there's any way to influence this at all, or if it's just luck. Oh, okay, so they chew through the wire. Oh, that's interesting. Well, that worked out. Anyway, in Legends of Localization, he was talking about how Little Mac is now a character in the Super Smash Bros. Series, and he, like, translates posts on Japanese message boards. Oh, it's like Jell-O. And it was pretty funny, because in Japan, most people don't know who Little Mac is, or they only have kind of a vague notion of who he is, because Punch-Out wasn't nearly as popular in Japan as it was here. So their frame of reference for Little Mac was a different game entirely. I forget what game it is. Some game that didn't come out here, that's for sure. It's kind of interesting. He does a lot of stuff like that. Like, he looks at, because the Angry Video Game Nerd has kind of a fan following in Japan. They fan sub it there. And he looks at comments on those videos, and he translates them to get an idea of, like, what people in Japan think of his videos and the games that he plays. Whoa. Oh, okay. So the Bomb Turtle kind of made a reappearance, but it looks more like a buzzy beetle. Can I get that thing to respawn? That was cute. Oh no, I guess not. Oh well. Oh, that's cool. I'm glad it makes an appearance. I mean, really, it's just a bomb, I guess, in a different... Oh, you know what? I bet the bell is a checkpoint. That makes perfect sense. If I die, I probably respawn near or at that bell. We have some I guess they're bullfish, not cowfish, since they have horns. Do cows have horns? I think they must, right? They're just not as big or pronounced as bullhorns. I don't know. I've never seen a cow in real life, so my experience with cattle is limited. Well, I guess I have seen cows in real life, but just at a distance. I don't know if they have horns or not. Oh, there it is. See, it has a fuse and everything. That's awesome. I really like that. We've killed 65 enemies so far. That's another very weird thing for a Mario game to do. Keep track of the number of enemies you've killed. Aw, man. I was looking at the manual for Super Mario Brothers recently for some reason. I forget how I came across it. But it makes a lot of references to killing enemies in the manual, which is very unusual for a Nintendo game. In Nintendo games, enemies are always knocked out, or defeated, or subdued, probably, but never killed. It's weird that even though it's a bomb, I can't lay the fuse with the fireball. You have to jump on it to activate it. Oh my god. Ooh, is it worth trying to get that one up? Probably not, since I have 12 lives. And I'm sure I want to fall on... Well, what the hell? Yep. Oh well. Lucky 13 lives. Very interesting music here. I'm really glad they didn't just rehash tunes from the NES Mario games for these games. That's kind of what modern Nintendo does. Well, I guess there are original tunes, but they do a lot of rehashing, especially in 3D Land and 3D World. Wow, there are a lot of 3-ups in this one. Say my odds are pretty good. Yeah. Cool that you're guaranteed to get something in the bonus game. There's no like, oops, try again, bad luck. Okay, so I was correct. Each of these nodes is a level, but this little fork here isn't a level. That it just splits off into two possible paths. Ah, there's that ant. Man, I just love the huge, expressive enemy sprites in this game. And it's not just an ant, it's an experience. I don't know what that means. I couldn't think of a way to finish that sentence. See, that's a situation where not having a pause there actually helps, because if there was a pause, it would have screwed up your aiming of your jump, and you would have been more likely to fall off. I really like that. I don't know why they insist on having that pause in every other Mario game ever made. That's not a part of the Mario Land series. Okay, can't go at that pipe. I have a feeling that's sort of enshrined in Nintendo canon at this point, and it's not likely to change anytime soon. I'm really surprised that they kept that pause in Mario 3D World, because the team behind 3D Land and 3D World is really smart. They made a lot of really smart decisions with those games, and I think another smart decision would have been to emulate the Mario Land power-up. There better be something good up here. I'm making a lot of backwards progress. Alright, there's a bunch of coins I can't get to. I could probably get those if I had the bunny ears. I haven't seen the bunny ears again since I collected and immediately... Oh, you can do the spin in the air too if you hit the down button. I didn't realize that. Oh my god. Well, that was kind of a dick move. What is this, Kaiser Mario Brothers? Oh, and I didn't get a checkpoint? Great. I don't know if I'm going up that long, winding, backwards path again. Okay, buddy. Aim your fireballs in a less meward direction. Really love the tiny little screeching noise it makes when you quickly change direction. It's similar to the Mario Brothers one, but I don't know, a little cuter. A lot of very cute things in this game. I thought there was a platform up here, like a moving platform that I could jump onto. Maybe not. Okay, I can't jump through that. Oh, there it is. I guess I should have, maybe this is the only way I can go. I didn't realize that. I'm not sure if the path continued, in the forward direction or not. Alright, gotta be careful. If I do hit that one-up block, then I need to hold a direction so I actually land on something. I kind of assumed I would hit solid ground at some point, which is why I didn't really steer myself. Okay. Wonder, can I still get that? No. Yeah, very granular control over how you can scroll the screen, which I like. Like, it's not just hold up and then the view springs back once you let go of it. You can actually, like, change the view to be however you like. Okay, I guess backwards is the only way I can go. It's kind of weird. See, you can, I guess that's as far down as it, well, no. That was odd. Okay, so you can't always control the view. It's dependent on your location, I guess. Why can't I step on that thing? It keeps thwarting my attempts to step on it. So yeah, here you can control the view however you want. Which I guess is important in a Game Boy game with large sprites. Because you can't fit as much information on the screen at once. You need pretty granular camera control. I guess as a camera. You don't really think of camera in the 2D sense. Ooh, man, that was another lost momentum. Oh, can I get back up there without going all the way back? Yeah, there we go. Alright. Oh, fudge. Man, this has been these levels seem pretty long so far. These videos are going to be longer than I thought they were. The whole reason... Oh, no. No, land on something. God bless it. The whole reason I'm doing these, instead of just jumping into Dungeon Hack, is because the Dungeon Hack videos are probably going to be pretty long. And I don't have a whole lot of time in the evenings right now, because this is the busiest time of year at work, and I'm working overtime, and my evenings are pretty short. So I thought, okay, well, until I have the time to fully devote to Dungeon Hack the way it deserves, I'm going to take a little break with these Mario games. Each video will be pretty short, probably about 10 minutes, but looks like that's no longer the case, starting in the second entry in the series. Alright, momentum. Oh, okay. Screw it. Man, I can't believe I did that 3 times in a row. Okay. Well, I can go straight to the boss, but I can't leave a job half finished, so on to B World. Let's see what's in this box real quick. Man, I was hoping there would be another carrot. I feel so bad for wasting the only carrot I found so far. Hello? Hitting a bee with fire here. There's no logically consistent reason a bee should be immune to fire. In fact, bees should be very vulnerable to fire. Man, that was wearing like... It either had gigantic eyes or it was wearing like a skull mask. I couldn't tell. Oh my god. Is that the queen? No, it's not big enough to be the queen. Besides, there's more than one. Must be a bumblebee. It's just a chubby bee. No royalty here. You guys will never be royals. I like this music. Very minimalistic. This and the dungeon music. Alright, I'm assuming I can't jump on that because it's sort of spiky looking. See, are those gigantic eyes or is that a skull mask? I'm thinking probably gigantic eyes. It's not very Nintendo-ish. Okay, you cannot do the spin jump when you aren't big. I was going to check and see if I could activate those from the top. Not that it would do me any good. Haven't seen any of the weird robot noises yet, which is a good sign. I had to go in and, V-Sync was one of the issues, or it might have been. I looked up Visual Boy Advance weird noises, and I found a forum where they suggested turning off V-Sync and setting the frame skip to 1 instead of 0. Well, okay, it suggested switching it to 1 instead of 0, but mine was actually set to 2, so I don't know what that means. Because frame skip of 1 means it's running in 30 frames per second, I think. Frame skip of 0 means 60 frames per second. And obviously, there's no reason for me to record in 60 FPS because YouTube doesn't support it. I wish it did, that would be pretty cool. But alas, for now we're stuck with a mere 30 FPS. And that's frames per second, not first-person shooter. Although 60 first-person shooters would be pretty cool, too. Wonder if that star is still there. Yeah. It's just hanging out. Alright, well, I was kind of hoping there would be more down there. But, a mushroom and a star, I'll take it. Oh, hey. Wonder if I... Nah, it resets your combo. Or maybe I just... didn't pick up that star fast enough to keep my combo going. Checkpoint. Man, these levels are big. I like it. I don't mind making long videos. It's just... with the overtime and all, I'm getting home at 5 p.m. and that gives me about 4.5 hours before I have to go to bed because I wake up at... around 5:30, so to get a good 8 hours of sleep. Man, I just know there's something good in here. I was wrong. Alright, let's see if I can bounce. Oh wait, there's a hidden block there. Nice. Nice! I'm one of those people who needs 8 hours of sleep to get by. I've tried getting by with less, and it did not work. Alright, so if I just... Alright, I want that middle one to be chewed through. Middle one and the bottom one, I think. I have no idea if there's actually a chance of me getting that if I want to. No, not really. Oh well. I guess I got a mushroom out of it. Aw, man, it resets your fire flower if you get the mushroom? That's jacked up. Okay, bird. Well, it's actually a whole level. I figured it would just be a boss level. Like, I enter that area, and it's just a boss fight. Okay, well, I got my flower back. PDQ. So, it's all good in the neighborhood. But yeah, I try getting by with 7 hours of sleep, 6 hours of sleep. I'm just not wired for it. Hi, Al. Oh, sorry I tried to shoot you. I didn't realize you were here to help me. Alright, I figured there would be nothing if I jumped to the left, but you have to try it. It's a Mario game, you have to try jumping everywhere. It's a good thing their heads are conveniently flat. Okay, so you can activate these things from the top, but if there was a power-up in it, it probably would have fallen out the bottom. Or maybe not, I don't know. The coins appeared to come out the top like normal. Oh hey! I got a star for doing nothing, or for shooting that bird with a flower. Alright, bunny ears! I can finally figure out... Oh wow. That is a very... Wait, can I no longer do... Oh yeah, I guess once you get the bunny ears, you can no longer do a spin jump. But man, look at that float! I can just stay in the air forever. Practically forever. I don't know if there's any way up there or not. Oh wait. Okay. Well, I can't do the spin jump, so that method is out. I guess I'm just not gonna get those blocks. I can get these blocks. Whoa. Oh my god. Okay. I wanted to play it safe, but luckily there's no way to go through that pipe, or else I probably would have got hit. Is it just me or am I jumping higher now? I can't tell. It looks like the bunny ears make you jump a little bit higher. Or maybe I just wasn't paying attention. I don't know. Okay, bird. Guess what? You ain't the only one with wings around here. Well, I sort of have wings. I have bunny ears that I can flap. They made me float. That's the next best thing to wings, right? Some very pleasant boss music. Dang it! Do your super predictable pattern more slowly. I mean, this is the first boss, so I'm not... Well, this is the first boss for me. It's not necessarily the first boss for everyone. Which is kind of interesting. Hell yeah, victory music. Well, look at that! We just got ourselves a golden coin. And judging by its placement in the arch, I'd say this is probably the intended first level. Alright, well, we have bested Tree Zone. Can I go back in there? Yeah, I can. If I want to, I guess. Ah, oh, bird's gone. I wonder what happens if I go to that level again. It just skips the boss fight. I don't know why you would want to. Alright, well, this has been Let's Play Super Mario Land 2. Hope you enjoyed it. Tune in tomorrow for a brand new episode in which we tackle, I don't know, maybe Turtle Zone? That one's pretty close. I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Goodbye.